And what exactly do you know about welding?
Not as much as I will after this video. I love welding. Hey, who said food?
I knew a welder once.
I've had enough of this welding nonsense.
We love welding.
First.
Hey guys, the Pro Ranger here, and welcome back to my welding series. This is the second part of my welding fabrication basics video. Today we're going to be taking the tools and parts that I showed you last time and we're going to put them into use. Let's get to it. Now, one of the most common connections you're going to make as a fabricator, and also a good place to start if you're brand new to this, is going to be the 90 degree connection. So we're going to take some 1x1 square tubing and we're going to create a square frame to get started. So let's go. I've gone ahead and drawn up our square, as you can see here. I gave us some dimensions. We're going to go with 12 inches by 12 inches, and of course it's 1 inch square material, so I threw in the 1 inch there. And we want 90 degree corners all the way around. Now there's two ways to make this 90 degree connection. One way is to simply butt this piece up against this piece and create our 90 degree condition. However, I don't like that connection. It's not very clean looking. So instead I'm going to go with a 45 degree cut on either end and we're going to create a weld all the way around so that it becomes a solid piece. There's no open ends like you see here.
Now I realize that not everyone has a chop saw or bandsaw available to make these 45 degree cuts. And that's okay. I would recommend, however, that you do pick one of these up if you plan on getting really into fabrication, because you're going to make a lot of cuts like this, and you're going to want something that can make light work out of these otherwise complicated cuts.
Now, to get started with our 45 degree cuts, we have to adjust our vise here. As you can see, it's set up as a 90 degree connection, so that means that the blade is perpendicular to the piece that's going to be mounted in here. So we need to turn this to an angle so that when we cut it, we get a 45 degree cut. So now, to adjust our vise, we need to just unlock it, move this out of the way, and slide this over until the 45 mark is lined up with the red line. Now I like to make double sure that it's locked down by using some vise grips. And next we place our piece in the vise. Put this end, this corner, slightly past the slot here. And we're gonna crank it down. And go ahead and make our cut. Now there's two things to keep in mind here. This end and these edges are very hot and sharp, so you want to be very careful. Now before we make our measurement to make our second cut, we need to remove the sharp burr that's on the end because that's going to affect our dimensions. Okay, now we have a nice clean edge we can measure off of to get our 12-inch dimension. Take that over to the chop saw and get it cut. Okay, so here's where our combination square comes in handy. As you can see, I've got my piece marked right here on the corner, but I can't exactly line this up evenly with that line. I can eyeball it, but I can't exactly get it perfect. So what I really want to do is have a mark on this side of the piece. And the way we do that is we take our combination square, which has a 45 degree angle here. We line it up with our mark, which is right there. And we can just give a mark there, or just go ahead and draw a line. And now we can use that mark to accurately line up our blade so that we get a nice perfect cut. And now we have both ends cleaned up and we can check our accuracy on the measurements. And we can see that it is exactly 12 inches. So we're going to make three more of these and weld them together. As you can see, our pieces now fit perfectly within our frame. The next step is to clamp them down, tack them, and weld them. Okay, we have multiple options here for clamping it down and getting everything squared up. They make these handy clamps. They're adjustable for different angles, and they basically clamp each piece in place into a 90 degree connection or 45 or whatever you have. And they're pretty nice. I like them. I don't use them very often. I prefer to do it this way, the old fashioned way, where you just use a square and you clamp your pieces down to the table. So we'll set that aside, and we'll go ahead and get this one clamped down to the table. It's good for little projects like this to go ahead and get as close to the corner as you can, that way you can get your clamps all the way around. Now it's a good idea to go ahead and get one piece clamped down to begin with. Now since that's nice and solid against the table, we can put our other one up here and square it off of this one.
So what I'm doing here is I'm making sure that there's no gap here.
I go ahead and clamp this piece down, keeping it square the entire time.
I've got a perfect 90 degree connection, ready to weld. But now that's only half of it. We gotta get the other half clamped down as well. So we're just gonna repeat the same process we did here on the other angles. Okay, now here's where some more tools come into play. Obviously, this clamp does not reach all the way over to here where I want it. That's why I have deep reach clamps. This allows me to reach all the way to that end so I can clamp that far end. Okay, now that we have everything clamped down and secure, and we've checked that it's square, all we're gonna do is tack weld the corners. Just one little zip, 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 zip. That way we can take it apart and check square again after we put that heat onto it to make sure. And if we like it at that point, then we can weld it. You don't want to just go and weld all of these and then take it apart and find out that it's not square. That's why it's very important just to do light tacks, check your square, clamp it back down, and weld it. Now that our four corners are tacked, we can unclamp everything. We're gonna wanna flip it over. But first, we wanna verify that it's square. The best way to do that is just to measure from corner to corner. We are 16 7/8. And 16 7/8. So, just by that alone, I know that it's square. Now we can go ahead and clamp it back down again. Now we can just go ahead and weld the four corners, flip it over, and weld the other four corners. The next step is just to take a grinder and smooth out all these welds so that the piece looks like one solid piece of metal. Well, there you have it. That's the finished product. Obviously, it's pretty boring and plain, but these types of connections, this type of a frame, is going to be used over and over again in fabrication. As I showed you before, my welding cart, for example, that's basically all this is. It's just one by one tubing, welded together at the corners as so, and put together into a cart format. This can be done using both square tubing, round tubing, angle irons, channel irons, I-beams, it's all the same. The cutting processes may be a little bit different, but essentially it's the same exact thing. You can see how adding elements like expanded metal, or sheet metal, or adding more tubing here. You can make tables, window coverings, you name it. This is kind of a good foundation to start with. A frame with these types of connections, the possibilities are endless. Well, just to give you a good example of what you can do with a frame design like this, this here is a clay thrower that we bought, and this trailer unit here is something that I built just out of 3/4 inch square tubing and 16 gauge sheet metal. Now, it's all exactly the same. It's all 45 degree cuts, just like this. You can see it's the same kind of a corner design. And I just made various sizes and put it all together, and it became a nice functioning unit. This is not something that had blueprints or designs that came along with it. I just put it together. You know, you just have to be creative. There's really no limit to what you can make with fabrication. That's why I like it so much. Well, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure you like, share, and favorite this video. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you next time.
Are you gonna shoot that?